Thank you, Mike. Today for your garden, well, with yesterday's high temperatures, maybe you were kind of tempted to get out in your garden and start clearing leaves or maybe digging in the dirt. There are helpful things to do in your garden in February, but there are some things you should not do. We just have too much winter left, and here is my petite little friend, gardening guru Linda Vauder, here with a quick guide for...
I was just saying that you could prune your own roses and prune your own trees, and you wouldn't even need a ladder.
I know. That's all I can do well is change light bulbs.
Yeah. Okay, so I know you don't garden a lot, so you probably, the past couple of days when it was beautiful outside, you may have not gotten too much of an itchy fingers to get out there in
the dirt. No, I did not have that kind of
passion.
But
your wife is a gardener, so she probably could barely resist.
Yeah, she was out there.
Yeah. Okay, so there are some things that it's acceptable and safe to do right now, but there are some other things we don't want to be doing because we'd really jump the gun.
Okay.
Okay, so I think four people asked me this week if they could prune their roses. Now, traditionally, I would say yes, because it's the winter time and you want to prune your roses when they're dormant. But in Oklahoma, it's been so warm, and a lot of times our roses don't ever really go dormant. So I would probably wait a couple of more weeks before I would prune them too much. However, with one exception, in any kind of pruning on your shrubs, your trees, your roses, any dead wood, you can go ahead and prune out.
Oh, okay, anything dead.
Any dead wood and clean up all of the, maybe the black spot leaves that are have kind of dropped around it. So go ahead and clean that up.
Okay.
When you do get to the point where you're pruning them later in the month, you want to make sure that whatever pruners you use, whether they're hand pruners or these big loppers.
Man, you are keeping it real here. Those things are,
I mean, I am woman, hear me roar. But you want to make sure that you take some of these antiseptic wipes with you because there are a number of viruses and diseases that can be spread, especially on roses. So in between each cut, you want to give your pruners a good swipe to prevent spreading that disease from one plant to another, or really from one cane to another.
Wow.
Now, if Mike is speaking the truth, and I pray that he is, we're going to get rain.
Yeah.
This isn't quite as important as it was earlier, and that's watering if it's really dry. Now, I love this. This is one of these hose guns, and you'll notice that it doesn't have a trigger to operate it, which can be difficult if you've got arthritic hands or you don't have a lot of strength in your hands. This one is great because it's just a lever that moves up and down. It's wonderful, and it will really take some of the stress off of your hands.
Where can you find that? Any garden store?
You can find this at any garden center, and in fact, they used to be kind of rare, but now you can find them everywhere.
Got about 45 seconds. What else do you have?
Okay, you do not want to plant your tomato seeds, your basil seeds, any of your hot weather vegetables, but you can. It is time to put out your onions, your potatoes, your radishes, almost lettuce time. Protect those little seedlings from rabbits and other dining critters.
Let me tell you, she knows what she's talking about. I follow her on Instagram. Her yard is unbelievable. But Linda, thank you again.
You're so
I appreciate
welcome.
It. Have a great weekend.
You too.
Linda's a great source, as you know, for gardening inspiration. Follow her on Instagram like I do, or on her website, lindavauder.com.